Good morning students of class 10. Today we are going to start history. So we are going to start chapter 1, that is the first war of independence. Dear students, why do we call it the first war of Indian independence? Let's begin with this discussion. In 1857, the first revolt started by Indians against the Britishers. As we all know that interpretation differs in history. How? Because the Britishers, those historians who belong to British nation, they termed this event as Sepoy mutiny. That was its immediate cause. But according to Indian historians, this event was called the first war of Indian independence, because first time people showed their guts and they tried to revolt against the Britishers. So that's why we call it the first war of independence. Okay, so what was the causes, what were the causes behind it? Let's understand this. Dear students, at that time the Britishers had annexed most of the territories of India. Yes, and at that time, by the mid 19th century, that is 1857, the Britishers just occupied, just we discussed that almost every part of the country. And at that time the rulers were the Mughals, and the Mughals existed at that time only in name. Actually they were just the puppets in the hand of the Britishers. Yes, so we can just see that by mid 19th century there was no any emperor of India who could hold the power over India. Yes, and in this way Britishers occupied India. And at that time when Britishers took control, the rule in their hands, all the sections of our society, they suffered a lot. From peasants to kings, every section they suffered a lot. How? The peasants had to pay high taxes, high revenues. The jamindars also, they lost their lands, territories. Yes, the craftsmen, artisans, they were also overburdened with the tax. And even the kings, their kingdoms were annexed by applying different policies by the Britishers. So in this way we can say that every section of the society was suffering, and these things became the cause for the revolt in 1857, because every section was angered against the Britishers because of their suppressive policies towards these all kind of people. Yes, so just we have discussed that in 1857, in mid 19th century, the Britishers, they occupied most of the part of India, and at the same time they oppressed the different sections of society, and this caused widespread discontentment, we can say anger, among the people, and thus it became the cause of the war. Yes, so now we are going to discuss about what were the different factors which actually caused the first war of independence. So there were many factors. So first of all, we will discuss today the political cause. Next, there is social and religious cause. Next, economic cause. then military cause, and finally the immediate cause. So we can see four or five factors are there, were there, and that led to the first war of independence. So what was the political cause? Political cause, it means it was related to the government. Yes, it is related to the kind of rule, why rulers of India, why the different kingdoms, they became against the Britishers. So that's why it is called the political cause. In political cause, we have to read the first one, and it is very important for examination point of view also. That is doctrine of lapse. Doctrine of lapse was the policy which was introduced by Lord Dalhousie, who was the then Governor General of India. According to this policy, any kingdom whose kings, suppose he had died, and he had no any male heir, male successor, in that case the kingdom would be left, the kingdom would be annexed by the Britishers. Yes, and suppose if any king had adopted any son, but the king had not taken permission from the Britishers, then the adopted son will not be called as a legal heir. So this was the policy, and in this way many kingdoms came under the control of the Britishers, and the first one was the Satara in 1849. It was annexed by the Britishers by this policy, doctrine of lapse. Next, Jhansi, we all know Rani Lakshmi Bai and her husband Gangadhar Rao, they had adopted a son, but they had not taken permission from the Britishers. So after Satara, Jhansi was also annexed by the Britishers, and Sambalpur, Jaipur. So in this way many kingdom came under the direct control of the Britishers by this policy. And when the kingdoms were occupied, the kings and the common people towards Britishers. Yes, and this became the cause for the revolt against Britishers. Now we are coming to the next political cause, that was discourtesy to Mughal Emperor. We all know that at that time Bahadur Shah Zafar was the emperor, was the king of Mughal Empire. But just as we discussed in the beginning, that when Britishers occupied those territories in mid 19th century, Mughal Empire existed only in name. So in the same way, the king Bahadur Shah Zafar also was just the king for the sake of name. Okay, and Lord Dalhousie also announced that the king Bahadur Shah Zafar and his wife Jinat Mahal would no longer stay in Red Fort, and they had to move to a place near Qutub Minar. Yes, and just we can say how the kings were humiliated by the Britishers. Again, Lord Canning also said that the successors of Bahadur Shah Zafar would no longer adopt the title of king. Yes, so in this way the discourtesy was towards the kings by the Britishers, and this became the cause for the First World War, because the kings became annoyed. One more thing under this topic, that was Nana Saheb, who was the adopted son of Baji Rao, Peshwa Baji Rao II, and earlier he was getting pension, annual pension, but now he was also stated that he would now not in the position to get that annual pension. Okay, and because and the cause was that the it was not personal, it was personal, not hereditary. Okay, and he was also shifted to Kanpur rather than the headquarter of Peshwas that was in Pune. So all these points that we discussed under this topic that discourtesy to Mughal emperor and other rulers of Indian of Indians, yes, so this way we can say that this became the cause. Next, annexation of Awadh, it also became the cause, political cause for the first war of independence. Awadh was annexed by the Britishers on the pretext of misgovernance and misrule. Yes, it means that the administration was not good, there was problems in administration. The king Wajid Ali Shah, Nawab Wajid Ali Shah, was not in the position to handle the kingdom in well manner. So that was the cause given by the Britishers, and by this just reason, by the name of in the name of misgovernance, Awadh was also annexed by the Britishers. And many of the soldiers who were in British army, they became annoyed by this when Awadh was annexed by the Britishers, because many of the soldiers in British army were belonged to Awadh. Yes, so thus we have understood that annexation of Awadh, this also became the political cause. Kings became angry. Yes, and the last political cause was unpopular administration. It means the British administration was not up to the mark. The people were not happy with the rule of Britishers. Why? Because just take the example, suppose we are approaching any officials with our grievances and they are not giving any attention to our problems. So in this way we can say the administration was not good. Many of the Indians were also removed from the offices. We can say we have heard that the soldiers were badly treated, they were said harsh words. Yes, so these were the rules. We English language was forced upon us, and many of the laws were not according to Indian custom and traditions. Yes, the rules and the laws are made according to the customs of that particular area. But when they came, suppose I am giving you an example like Sati system, it was banned. Okay, but Sati was, though it was very bad system, but still the in India it was practiced. So in this way they have just forgotten our customs and traditions, and they made such kind of rules, yes, which just angered the common people of India. So thus we have completed all the political causes that became reason, factor, one of the factors for the first war of independence in 1857. The rest causes we will discuss in the rest classes. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.